The Giver by Lois Lowry, Chapter 14.
It was much the same, this memory, though the hill seemed to be a different one, steeper, and the snow was not falling as thickly as it had before. It was colder, also, Jonas perceived. He could see, as he sat waiting at the top of the hill, that the snow beneath the sled was not falling as thickly as it had before. It was colder, also, Jonas perceived. He could see, as he sat waiting at the top of the hill, that the snow beneath the sled was not thick and soft as it had been before, but hard and cold with bluish ice. The sled moved forward, and Jonas groaned with delight, looking forward to the breathtaking sled and soft as it had been before, but hard and cold with bluish ice. The sled moved forward, and Jonas groaned with delight, looking forward to the breathtaking slide down through the invigorating air. But the runners, this time, couldn't slide through the frozen expanse as they had on the other snow-cushioned hill. The skitters slid down through the invigorating air. But the runners, this time, couldn't slide through the frozen expanse as they had on the other snow-cushioned hill. The skitters sideways on the sled gator speed. Jonas pulled at the rope, trying to steer, but the stiffness and speed took control from his hand and he was no longer enjoying the feeling of freedom. Sideways on the sled gator speed. Jonas pulled at the rope, trying to steer, but the stiffness and speed took control from his hand and he was no longer enjoying the feeling of freedom, but instead, terrified, was at the mercy of the wheel acceleration downward over ice. Sideways, spinning, the sled hit a bump in the hill and Jonas was jarred loose and threw violently, but instead, terrified, was at the mercy of the wheel acceleration downward over ice. Sideways, spinning, the sled hit a bump in the hill and Jonas was jarred loose and threw violently into the air. He fell, with his leg twist under him, and could hear the crack of bone. His face scraped along jagged edge of ice, and when he came, at last into the air, he fell, with his leg twist under him, and could hear the crack of bone. His face scraped along jagged edge of ice, and when he came, at last, to a stop, he lay shocked and still, feeling nothing at first but fear. Then, the fierce wave of pain, he gasped. It was as if a hatchet lay lodged in his legs. To a stop, he lay shocked and still, feeling nothing at first but fear. Then, the fierce wave of pain, he gasped. It was as if a hatchet lay lodged in his leg, slithing through each nerve with a hot blade. In his agony, he perceived the word, fire, and felt flames licking at the torn bone and flesh. He tried to move, slithing through each nerve with a hot blade. In his agony, he perceived the word, fire, and felt flames licking at the torn bone and flesh. He tried to move, and could not. The pain grew. He screamed. There was no answer. Sobbing, he turned in his head and vomited onto the frozen snow. Move, and could not. The pain grew. He screamed. There was no answer. Sobbing, he turned in his head and vomited onto the frozen snow. Blood dripped from his face into the vomit. No! He cried, and the sun disappeared into the empty landscape into the wind. Then suddenly he was in the annex room again. Blood dripped from his face into the vomit. No! He cried, and the sun disappeared into the empty landscape into the wind. Then suddenly he was in the annex room again, writing on the bed.
His face was wet with tears. Able to move now, he rocked his own body back and forth, breathing deeply to release the remembered pain. He sat,
writing on the bed.
His face was wet with tears. Able to move now, he rocked his own body back and forth, breathing deeply to release the remembered pain. He sat and looked at his own leg, where it lay straight on the bed, unbroken. The brutal slave of pain was gone, but the leg edged horrible, still, and his face felt raw. And looked at his own leg, where it lay straight on the bed, unbroken. The brutal slave of pain was gone, but the leg edged horrible, still, and his face felt raw.
May I have a level of pain, please?
He begged. It was always providing his everyday life for the bruises and wounds. For a mashed finger, a stomach ache.
May I have a level of pain, please?
He begged. It was always providing his everyday life for the bruises and wounds. For a mashed finger, a stomach ache, a skinned knee, from a fall from a bike. There was always a dab of anesthetic ointment, or a feel. Or in service instance, an injection that broke complete and instantaneous in knee, from a fall from a bike. There was always a dab of anesthetic ointment, or a feel. Or in service instance, an injection that broke complete and instantaneous deliverance. But the giver said no, and looked away. Limping, Jonas walked home, pushing his bicycle that evening. The sunburn paint had been delivered, but the giver said no and looked away. Limping, Jonas walked home, pushing his bicycle that evening. The sunburn paint had been so small in comparison and had not stayed with him. But this age lingered. It was not endurable, as the pain on the heel had been. Jonas tried to be so small in comparison and had not stayed with him. But this age lingered. It was not endurable, as the pain on the heel had been. Jonas tried to be brave. He remembered that the chief elder had said he was brave. "Is something wrong, Jonas?" his father asked at the evening meal. "You're so quiet tonight. Are you feeling well?" "Brave." He remembered that the chief elder had said he was brave. "Is something wrong, Jonas?" his father asked at the evening meal. "You're so quiet tonight. Are you feeling well? Wouldn't you like some medication?" But Jonas remembered the rules. No medication for anything related to his training, and no discussion of his training. At the time for sure, "Wouldn't you like some medication?" But Jonas remembered the rules. No medication for anything related to his training, and no discussion of his training. At the time for sharing of feelings, he simply said that he felt tired, that his school lesson had been unusually demanding that day. He went to his sleeping room early, and from no feelings, he simply said that he felt tired, that his school lesson had been unusually demanding that day. He went to his sleeping room early, and from behind the closed door, he could hear his parents and sister laughing as they gave Gabriel his evening bath. "They have never enough pain," he thought. Through his closed door, he could hear his parents and sister laughing as they gave Gabriel his evening bath. "They have never enough pain," he thought. The realization made him feel desperately lonely, and he rubbed his throbbing leg. He eventually slept. Again and again he dreamed of the anguish and desolation on the Forasquen Hill. The daily training continued, and now it always included pain. The agony of the fractured leg began to seem no more than a mild discomfort as the kill. Giver led Jonas plainly, little by little, into the deep and terrible suffering of the past. Each time, in his kindness, Giver led Jonas plainly, little by little, into the deep and terrible suffering of the past. Each time, in his kindness, the Giver ended the afternoon with a color file memory of pleasure. A brick sail on a blue-green lake, a meadow dot with yellow with flowers. An orange sunset behind mountains. It was not a note to assuage the pain that Jonas was beginning now to know. "Why?" Jonas asked. Him after he had received a torturous memory in which he had been neglected and duped. He anger had caused excruciating span in his empty, distant stomach. He lay on the bed, aching. "Why do you and I have to hold these memories? It gives us wisdom," in his empty, distant stomach. He lay on the bed, aching. "Why do you and I have to hold these memories? It gives us wisdom," the giver replied. "Without wisdom, I could not fulfill my function of advice in the committee of elders when they call upon me." "But what wisdom do you get from anger?" the giver replied. Jonas groaned. His stomach still hurt, for the memory unended. "Some years ago," the giver told him, "before you built a lot of cities," Jonas groaned. His stomach still hurt, for the memory unended. "Some years ago," the giver told him, "before you built a lot of citizens petitioned the committee of elders." They want to increase the rate of bears. They want his beard mother to be a sin for bears instead of three. Since petition the Committee of Elders. They want to increase the rate of bears. They want his beard mother to be a sin for bears instead of three. So that the population will increase and there will be more laborers available. Jonas note. Listening. That makes sense. The idea was that certain families so that the population will increase and there will be more laborers available. Jonas note. Listening. That makes sense. The idea was that certain family units could accommodate an additional child. Jonas note again. Mine cool. He point out. We have Gabriel this year and its fans could accommodate an additional child. Jonas note again. Mine cool. He point out. We have Gabriel this year and its fan, having a third child. The Committee of Elders saw my advice, the giver said. It made sense to them, too bad it was a new idea. And they, having a third child, the Committee of Elders saw my advice, the giver said. It made sense to them, too bad it was a new idea. And they came to me for wisdom. And you use your memories? The giver said yes. And the strongest memory that came was anger. It came from many generations back, centuries back. Came to me for wisdom. And you use your memories? The giver said yes. And the strongest memory that came was anger. It came from many generations back, centuries back. The population had gotten so big that anger was everywhere. Excruciating hunger and starvation, it was followed by warfare. Warfare? It was a constant. The population had gotten so big that anger was everywhere. Excruciating hunger and starvation, it was followed by warfare. Warfare? It was a concept Jonas did not know, but hunger was familiar to him now. Unconsciously, he rubbed his own abdomen, recalling of the pain of its unfulfilled needs. Concept Jonas did not know, but hunger was familiar to him now. Unconsciously, he rubbed his own abdomen, recalling of the pain of its unfulfilled needs. So you describe that to them? They don't want to hear about pain. They just seek the advice. I simply advise them against increasing the... So you describe that to them? They don't want to hear about pain. They just seek the advice. I simply advise them against increasing the population. But you say that was before my birth. They hardly ever come to you for advice. Only when they... What was the population? But you say that was before my birth. They hardly ever come to you for advice. Only when they... What was it you said? When they have a problem they've never faced before. When did it happen last? Do you remember the day when the plane flew over the community? You said. When they have a problem they've never faced before. When did it happen last? Do you remember the day when the plane flew over the community? Yes, it was scary. So were they. They prepared to shut it down. But they took my advice. I told them to wait. But how did you... Yes, it was scary. So were they. They prepared to shut it down. But they took my advice. I told them to wait. But how did you know? How did you know the pilot was lost? I didn't. I used my wisdom. From the memories, I knew that there had been times in the past, terrible times. No, how did you know the pilot was lost? I didn't. I used my wisdom. From the memories, I knew that there had been times in the past, terrible times, when people had destroyed others in haste, in fear, and had brought about their own construction. Jonas realized something. That means when people had destroyed others in haste, in fear, and had brought about their own construction. Jonas realized something. That means, he said slowly, that you have memories of destruction, and you have to give to me, too, because I have to get the wisdom, the giver, he said slowly. That you have memories of destruction, and you have to give to me, too, because I have to get the wisdom, the giver note. But it will hurt, Jonas said. I wasn't a question. It will hurt terrible, the giver agreed. But why can't every note? But it will hurt, Jonas said. I wasn't a question. It will hurt terrible, the giver agreed. But why can't everyone have the memories? I think it would seem a little easier if the memories were shared. You and I would have to bear so much by ourselves. One half the memories. I think it would seem a little easier if the memories were shared. You and I would have to bear so much by ourselves. If everybody took apart. The giver sighed. You're right, he said. But everyone would be born and pained. They don't want that. And that if everybody took apart. The giver sighed. You're right, he said. But everyone would be born and pained. They don't want that. And that's the real reason the recital is so vital to them. And so honored. They said, let me, and you, to life that born from themselves. When did they is the real reason the recital is so vital to them. And so honored. They said, let me, and you, to life that born from themselves. When did they decide that? Jonas asked angrily. It wasn't fair. Let's change it. How do you suggest we do that? I've never been able to think of a way. Decide that? Jonas asked angrily. It wasn't fair. Let's change it. How do you suggest we do that? I've never been able to think of a way. And he's supposed to be the one with all the wisdom. But there are two of us now. Jonas sighed eagerly. Together we can think of something. And he's supposed to be the one with all the wisdom. But there are two of us now. Jonas sighed eagerly. Together we can think of something. The giver watched him with a wry smile. Why can't we choose a plea for a chain of rules? Jonas suggests. The giver laughed. Then Jonas too watched him with a wry smile. Why can't we choose a plea for a chain of rules? Jonas suggests. The giver laughed. Then Jonas too chuckled recurrently. The decision was made long before my time of yours, the giver said, and before the previous receiver and he quaked back and chuckled recurrently. The decision was made long before my time of yours, the giver said, and before the previous receiver and he quaked back and back and back. Jonas repeated the familiar phrase. Sometimes it had seemed humorous to him. Sometimes it had seemed meaningful and important. Now, come back and back. Jonas repeated the familiar phrase. Sometimes it had seemed humorous to him. Sometimes it had seemed meaningful and important. Now, it was ominous. I mean, he knew that nothing could be changed. The new child, Gabriel, was growing and successful paced the test. It was ominous. I mean, he knew that nothing could be changed. The new child, Gabriel, was growing and successful paced the test of maturity that the nurturers gave each month. He could sit alone now, could reach for and grasp a small play of discs. And he test of maturity that the nurturers gave each month. He could sit alone now, could reach for and grasp a small play of discs. And he had 60 during the daytime hours. Father report he was cheerful and seemed of normal intelligence. But he reminded Fred had 60 during the daytime hours. Father report he was cheerful and seemed of normal intelligence. But he remained fretful at night, whimpering often, needing frequent attention. After all this extra time I put in with him. Father said full at night, whimpering often, needing frequent attention. After all this extra time I put in with him. Father said one evening after Gabriel had been paid and was lying for the moment, hugging his hypoplacidine in the small. One evening after Gabriel had been paid and was lying for the moment, hugging his hypoplacidine in the small crib that had replaced the basket. I hope they're not going to decide to release him. Maybe it would be for the best. Small crib that had replaced the basket. I hope they're not going to decide to release him. Maybe it would be for the best, Mother suggests. I know you don't mind getting up with him at night, but the lack of sleep is awfully hard for me. If they really, Mother suggests. I know you don't mind getting up with him at night, but the lack of sleep is awfully hard for me. If they release Gabriel. Can we get another new chill as a visitor? Asked Lily. He was kneeling beside the crib, making funny face at the little one, who lay scared. Can we get another new chill as a visitor? Asked Lily. He was kneeling beside the crib, making funny face at the little one, who was smiling back at her. Jonah's mother rolled her eyes in dismay. No, father said, smiling. He ruffled Lily's hair. Smiling back at her, Jonah's mother rolled her eyes in dismay. No, father said, smiling. He ruffled Lily's hair. It's very rare, anyway, that a new child status is as uncertain as Gabriel's. It probably won't happen again for a long time. It's very rare, anyway, that a new child status is as uncertain as Gabriel's. It probably won't happen again for a long time. Anyway, he sighed. They won't make the decision for a while. Right now, we're all preparing for a release we're probably to have to make pain. Anyway, he sighed. They won't make the decision for a while. Right now, we're all preparing for a release we're probably to have to make very soon. There is a beard mother who's expecting twin males next month. Oh, dear, said mother, shaking her head. It's very soon. There is a beard mother who's expecting twin males next month. Oh, dear, said mother, shaking her head. If they're identical, I hope you're not the one assigned. I am, I'm next on the list. I'll have to select the one to be nurtured. If they're identical, I hope you're not the one assigned. I am, I'm next on the list. I'll have to select the one to be nurtured and the one to be realized. It's usually not hard though. Usually, it's just a matter of beer weight. We realize the smaller of the two and the one to be realized. It's usually not hard though. Usually, it's just a matter of beer weight. We realize the smaller of the two. Jonas listened in full suddenly about the bride and how, standing him there. He had to wonder what lay elsewhere. Jonas listened in full suddenly about the bride and how, standing him there. He had to wonder what lay elsewhere. Was there someone there, waiting? Who would reside the tiny relays twin? Would it grow up elsewhere? Not knowing ever. Was there someone there, waiting? Who would reside the tiny relays twin? Would it grow up elsewhere? Not knowing ever. That in this community life of being whole look exactly the same? For a moment he felt a tiny, fluttering hope that the new was quite full. That in this community life of being whole look exactly the same? For a moment he felt a tiny, fluttering hope that the new was quite foolish. He hoped that it would be Larissa waiting. Larissa, the old woman he had paid. He remembered his sparkling eyes, her soft voice, foolish. He hoped that it would be Larissa waiting. Larissa, the old woman he had paid. He remembered his sparkling eyes, her soft voice, her loud chuckle. Fiona had told him recently that Larissa had been released at her wonderful ceremony. But he knew that the old words, her loud chuckle. Fiona had told him recently that Larissa had been released at her wonderful ceremony. But he knew that they all were not giving children to rise. Larissa's life elsewhere would be quiet and serene as befied the old. She would not welcome the not giving children to rise. Larissa's life elsewhere would be quiet and serene as befied the old. She would not welcome the responsibility of nurturing a new child who need feeding and care, and would likely crying at night. Mother, father, responsibility of nurturing a new child who need feeding and care, and would likely crying at night. Mother, father, he said, the idea coming to him unexpectedly. Why don't we put Gabriel's crib in my room tonight? I know how to feed and comfort him. He said, the idea coming to him unexpectedly. Why don't we put Gabriel's crib in my room tonight? I know how to feed and comfort him. And
It would let you and Father get some sleep. Father looked doubtful. You slept so soundly, Jonas. What if he's... And it would let you and Father get some sleep. Father looked doubtful. You slept so soundly, Jonas. What if his restlessness didn't wake you? It was Lily so answered that. If no one goes to thank Gabriel. She pointed out. His restlessness didn't wake you? It was Lily so answered that. If no one goes to thank Gabriel. She pointed out. He gets very loud. He'd wake all of us. If Jonas slept through it. Father Lowry. You're right, Lily Billy. I'm very loud. He'd wake all of us. If Jonas slept through it. Father Lowry. You're right, Lily Billy. All right, Jonas, let's try it. Just for tonight. It'll take the night off and we'll let Mother get some sleep too. Gabriel sleeps. All right, Jonas, let's try it. Just for tonight. It'll take the night off and we'll let Mother get some sleep too. Gabriel sleeps soundly for the earliest part of the night. Jonas, in his bed, lay awake for a while. From time to time, he raised himself on one elbow soundly for the earliest part of the night. Jonas, in his bed, lay awake for a while. From time to time, he raised himself on one elbow, looking over at the crib. The new chill was on his stomach, his arm relaxed beside his head, his eyes closed, and his breathing regular and undisturbed, looking over at the crib. The new chill was on his stomach, his arm relaxed beside his head, his eyes closed, and his breathing regular and undisturbed. Finally, Jonas slept too. Then as the middle hours of the night approached, the noise of Gabe's relentlessness woke Jonas. The new chill disturbed. Finally, Jonas slept too. Then as the middle hours of the night approached, the noise of Gabe's relentlessness woke Jonas. The new chill was turning under his cover, flailing his arms, and beginning to whimper. Jonas rose and went to him. Gently, he patted Gabriel's back. Was turning under his cover, flailing his arms, and beginning to whimper. Jonas rose and went to him. Gently, he patted Gabriel's back. Sometimes, that was all it took to lull him back to sleep. But the new chill still squirmed fretfully under his hand. Sometimes that was all it took to lull him back to sleep. But the new chill still squirmed fretfully under his hand. Still playing rhythmically, Jonas began to remember the wonderful sight that the giver had given him not long before. A bright, breezy day on a cloud. Still playing rhythmically, Jonas began to remember the wonderful sight that the giver had given him not long before. A bright, breezy day on a clear, turquoise lake, and above him the white sail of the boat billowing as he moved along in the brisk wind. Clear, turquoise lake, and above him the white sail of the boat billowing as he moved along in the brisk wind. He was not the way of giving the memory, but suddenly he realized that it was becoming thinner, that it was slipping from his hand into the being of. He was not the way of giving the memory, but suddenly he realized that it was becoming thinner, that it was slipping from his hand into the being of the new child. Gabriel became quiet. Starlet Jonas pulled back what was left of the memory with a burst of will. He removed his hand from the new child. Gabriel became quiet. Starlet Jonas pulled back what was left of the memory with a burst of will. He removed his hand from the little bag and stood quietly beside the crib. To himself, he called the memory of the sail forward again. It was still there, but back and stood quietly beside the crib. To himself, he called the memory of the sail forward again. It was still there, but the sky was less blue. The gentle motion of the boat slower. The water of the lake more murky and cold. He kept it for a while. So the sky was less blue. The gentle motion of the boat slower. The water of the lake more murky and cold. He kept it for a while. Soothing
his own nervousness at what had occurred, then let it go and return to his bed. Once more, toward down, the new thing, his own nervousness at what had occurred, then let it go and return to his bed. Once more, toward down, the new chill woke and cried out. Again Jonas went to him. This time he quite deliberately placed his hand firmly on the new chill woke and cried out. Again Jonas went to him. This time he quite deliberately placed his hand firmly on Gabriel's back and relaxed the rest of the calming day on the lake. Again Gabriel slept, but now Jonas lay awake, thinking. He no longer was back, and relays the rest of the calming day on the lake. Again Gabriel slept, but now Jonas lay awake, thinking. He no longer had any more than a wisp of the memory, and he felt a small lack where it had been. He could ask the giver for another sail. He no longer had any more than a wisp of the memory, and he felt a small lack where it had been. He could ask the giver for another sail, he knew. A sail perhaps on ocean, next time, for Jonas had a memory of ocean. Now, and knew what it was. He knew. A sail perhaps on ocean, next time, for Jonas had a memory of ocean. Now, and knew what it was. He knew that there were sailboats there too. In memories, the two be archived. He wondered, though, if the soul confessed to the king that there were sailboats there too, in memories the two be archived. He wondered, though, if the soul confessed to the giver that he had given a memory away. He was now yet qualified to be a giver himself. Now had Gabriel been selected to be a receiver, giver that he had given a memory away. He was now yet qualified to be a giver himself. Now had Gabriel been selected to be a receiver. That he had this power frightened him. He decided not to tell. That he had this power frightened him.